Monday night at 7. The time has come.
The signs are all around us.
There's no need to hide.
Let's make a break for it!
It's the Cartoon Network invaded event you've been waiting for.
No, they're aliens and they're here to steal our cheese!
Give us your cheese!
Catch all four invaded episodes back to back. And then it's the grand finale with the brand new episode of The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy.
Got it.
Monday night at 7 on Cartoon Network.
Happy Halloween and welcome back to Cartoon Network Invaded Reviewed. I tried making a Donnie Darko costume and it didn't work that well. Yeah, let's just get into this. Well, we have reached the conclusion of our look at the Cartoon Network Invaded Marathon, and what better way to end it than with the Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. I talked about this show last Halloween when I covered their failed spin-off pilot, Underfist, but just as a reminder, I love this show. It somehow managed to be great despite encompassing two things I despise, gross-out humor and mean-spiritedness, but it managed to be really funny and created a lineup of very memorable characters. So how does their Invaded episode hold up? Does it conclude the event in a satisfactory way? Well, let's find out with Billy and Mandy, Moon the Moon. It starts with Billy watching TV while using his action figure to pick his nose, and yes, that's a sentence I just said. Billy's dad tells him to go to bed, but Billy doesn't want to.
When I'm big, we're gonna go on real adventures! Action-packed, super-sized, rainbow-filled adventures!
Oh, so you're gonna go hunt a unicorn. Be careful, I've heard they're douchebags.
We're jerks, okay? We have more hair than we know what to do with, and we keep it to ourselves just to tick humans off.
But it turns out Billy won't have to wait long for an adventure as the aliens decide to stop in Ennsville. Billy goes to investigate and comes across a crop... face. Don't worry, it turns out to be Spurg, who just enjoys beating up corn. But not long afterward, they are abducted by one of the flying saucers. The aliens fuck with Billy for a little bit, but eventually let him go.
My cereal's too dry!
Woofy doody! The milk is gone! And the butter! Cheese! Even the tofu!
All the milk and cheese at my house is missing too.
This sounds like the kind of mystery that can't be solved in 11 minutes.
I love the fourth wall breaks in this show. They always lead to some of the biggest laughs. Billy tells them that the aliens are taking all the cheese products in town because they used up all their cheese on the moon. It turns out the aliens planted a chip in Billy's brain after torturing Spurg the same way they tortured Samson. Thankfully, Billy was able to escape by going all Neo on their asses.
You guys are the f***ing worst! Your gods are alive! You! Nature!
But they also planted a bomb in Spurg's brain that will explode in 12 hours.
Oh man! And it's my birthday!
So it turns out the aliens need the cheese in order to power their machine since they have used up all the cheese on the moon.
Man, I hate it when Billy's right.
The aliens leave a giant present that turns out to be a little monster that turns into a big monster and shoots processed cheese out of its armpits. Grim says that he will come up with a plan to stop the aliens before going to a commercial.
And they lived happily ever after.
Well, shit, that was a lame conclusion to this crossover special. The group are abducted and taken to the moon, which is being mined for all its cheese.
You must understand that the moon people are a kind, gentle race. We are only interested in cheese and destroying your planet.
Makes sense.
When our moon bots finish their job tonight, the moon will be full, and every moon person will become a werewolf.
Snarling.
No. I'm sorry. Could you repeat that?
When our moon bots finish their job tonight, the moon will be full, and every moon person will become a werewolf.
Well, I can honestly say I did not expect this alien invasion special to end with werewolves. They plan to devour all the humans on Earth and replace them with cardboard cutouts. The four are then thrown into an arena where they are put into a battle royale to the death. My question is, what happens to the winner?
You bore us. This is like watching soccer. Release the moon beast!
Okay.
Why am I getting flashbacks to Attack of the Clones? Thankfully, the Moon Beast is more interested in singing than killing them, and they manage to escape. On Earth, the lack of cheese is starting to affect the population as the mice move out and Billy's dad can't have pizza with tofu on it. Back on the moon, the group can somehow breathe in space and magnetize their feet in order to walk outside. They get inside and after an epic battle, they take over the ship. Unfortunately, the aliens have already begun to transform into alien werewolf hybrids. Which, if that's not a thing that exists, make that a thing that exists. Billy is attacked, but Grimm and Mandy manage to escape into a vent and we get a Star Wars reference as they are trapped in cheese spread. Spurg is hiding in a closet when Billy finds him and turns into a werewolf. Don't worry though, Spurg escapes. Just before Mandy and Grimm are about to be turned into a BLT, Grimm summons his scythe and turns them into superheroes.
No!
We get a final battle that's a parody of the 1960s Batman show for some reason, and Spurg has isolated himself in a room waiting for his head to explode. Don't worry, he lived, and he's continuing his bully ways despite the lack of head. Mandy and Grimm have now committed their lives to fighting aliens across the galaxy, Billy is at home, still stuck as a werewolf, and Dr. Brainiac, Billy's toy that was brought to life, is given Frankie's final package, which contains a sweater. But since he hates sweaters, he decides to blow up the Earth. Oh, so that must mean why Frankie was tortured all throughout Cheez-A-Go-Go. She was the one who would lead to the destruction of the entire planet. Okay, it all makes sense now. And they all lived happily ever after.
What happened out there? Operation Let's Get Some Cheese was a flawless plan!
I have analyzed the film of our operation, and I have found key areas where the Earthlings outsmarted us. For instance, the Earthlings are quite resistant to our undie-snapping torture. Apparently, they've built up a tolerance for it on each other. Barbarians.
Well, what about our undercover agents?
Sadly to say, sir, each one failed to achieve their primary target.
I always knew Plank was up to no good.
The aliens decide to suck out the brain juice of five individuals. Unfortunately, those individuals were Fred Fredberger, Ed, Skip, Cheese, and Slips, which causes the commander to become an idiot.
Yes!
And that was Billy and Mandy Moon the Moon. How does it stack up against the other four shows? Well, this was probably the funniest of the episodes, and did have a nice epilogue. However, I was a little disappointed that it didn't end the special with some big crossover battle, although that's not what the show really is. I'd say it's second best. First would be The Eds Are Coming, third is Cheez-A-Go-Go, fourth is the Camp Lazlo episodes, and last is That Darn Platypus. So how was the event overall? Well, I gotta say that this was a really creative crossover idea, and the execution was brilliant. What I love is that all five shows tell an overarching story about this invasion. In the first episode they are contacted, in the second one they arrive, in the third they start to interact with the humans, in the fourth they begin their plan, and in the fifth they invade. There's little connections between all the episodes that you wouldn't notice on your first viewing, such as that Rick had cheese in the My Gym Partner's a Monkey episode, before we even knew the aliens' plan. Each one has a paranoid character, all of them have similar UFOs and aliens, we get to see the aftermath of certain episodes and other ones that follow, and of course the boxes Frankie sends out in the Fosters episode, are all featured in the next four. But despite all this, they all can stand alone. You don't need to see any episode past Fosters to get a conclusion, or any episode before Billy and Mandy to get a setup. This was so good that I kind of want to see Cartoon Network do this again with some of their more current shows. Seriously, imagine regular shows, Steven Universe, Uncle Grandpa, Gumball, and Wee Bear Bears all connected in some way. Some people may feel disappointed that there isn't much in terms of interaction between the characters of each show, which is usually one of the best parts of a crossover, but I don't mind because this means you don't have to watch all five shows in order to understand who the characters are. If you haven't seen all five of these episodes back to back since 2007, check it out again. So I hope you all have a very happy Halloween, and I will see you all next time. Well, looks like I got some work to do. So again, I hope you all have a very nice Halloween, and I will see you all next time. And we're going to count down all of them. So how does the show work when you bring it? So how does the invaded episode show up? Fuck. And no, I refuse to make a Perry the Platypus joke because I refuse to reference better shows in... Too many R's. Oh my god, it's the brain-sucking alien from Brilliant Man! So how does their invaded episode hold up? Well, and we're gonna be cover... We'll be looking at how it all works as it... You know, normally I don't like to... I refuse to reference Phineas and Ferb because I refuse to reference... Under protest that we do not reference better shows. Almost had it there, couldn't breathe. Protest that we do not... Fuck! Under protest that we do not... We do not reference other... Be careful, I've heard they're a bit... Alright, this is the Fosters episode. And yes, every single... Why does my head look like a bobblehead? And yes, every title is in making a Phineas and Ferb joke under... Why can't I do this fucking line? Which, if that's not a thing, I don't have a friend's in... Bad Max. Yeah, I had to get... Frankie, do not talk one. How does it stack up? So now the aliens on our... Fuck. So next week we conclude... It may not be important now, but it'll become... So next week we conclude by heading to... Well, we'll have to find out next week when we return to... So the aliens have been called and they're... Good luck editing all that. Peace!